Hello everyone, and welcome to the sixth completed settlement in the Megabuild project. We'll be arriving here shortly. Please make sure your seatbelts are securely fastened and that your tray tables are in their upright and locked positions. We are coming in here to Graygarden on the vertibird because I'm in survival mode. This is my fast travel.
Good landing spot. I'll have you on the ground shortly.
And dismount. So the first feature of the Graygarden settlement is the helipad, which he landed right on. See you later, buddy. See you in a bit. So that's a fast travel mat, and I use that little orange thing to remind me where it's at because those little rugs are hard to see. But yeah, he landed right on it. So here we are on the overpass at Graygarden. I didn't do any let's builds on this because I spent way too long going back and forth on what I wanted to do with it. And it would have been like a 4-hour epic saga, and that's just not going to work. So up on top here, we have the player house. This is his home here when he's at Graygarden. This is a sort of random thing. It kind of grew on its own. Oh, so here's the stairway. I like this little stairway. We'll go over the top here and just take a little tour of the house. So we've got the little visiting coffee thing, some scenic stuff. They've got their little snacks where they can just sort of hang out, look out at the downtown area, see Mass Fusion over there. More benches and stuff over here. You can see a long way from up here, can't you? So we'll go over here. And you need a Neotronic machine on the back of that semi. I back the whole house up against the back of that truck and just put an Eatatronic right on top of the back of it. But the typical workshop, some snacks out of the machine that they're just going to wait to eat. The Mr. Handy Fuel that we've all known to come and love. And his standard stuff set up there. We go upstairs here. Another pretty good view. You can see sunshine in the distance. Those little red things in the distance is sunshine. So we'll go around here. Another eating area. A little balcony door you can see over the top there. And then over here, amusement hour. A stool and a sniper rifle, some ammo. Can definitely see Beantown Brewery. Can't see Oberland, but you could if it drew in there. And then his bedroom over here. The standard stuff. We'll go up to the balcony here. Observation deck, so to speak. Got a camera, some liquor, some smokes. He's like, I'm good. And of course, Jalbert, Lexington. You can really see everything from up here. It's kind of crazy. So what I did on this one is I built him an escape hatch. So let's say he's sleeping, right? He's down here sleeping and something happens. He goes up the stairs, goes over to the side, takes the slide out to the top of the truck here, and then just comes down the outside. So there's his house. Now we'll go down the bridge. That's the signal beacon there. Just got a red light marker for night. So there's Graygarden down there. We'll be checking that out in a second. So here we go down the stairs. If you're on Reddit, you've seen pictures of this thing before, where I modified it like 16 different times to get it to look like it was supported. And I figured those three things with all the guy wires should be enough to do the trick. I haven't fallen off this thing yet. I'm kind of surprised by that. So we'll go down the stairs here. Oh yeah, this is the thing I used to show y'all the conduit thing. This is the structure I was building at the time. So this is a Brotherhood of Steel outpost. What I've decided is that the robots are going to just run their stuff, and they're going to have a couple of people up on top, sending messages, checking the signals. Just a skeleton crew of Brotherhood guys to keep an eye on things. So this is a real, real bare-bones setup. They've got their cooking station, some implements and utensils and stuff. Got my superstar here in his bomber jacket looking all styling. Little communal eating area. They don't need a lot of space. There's only going to be like 3 or 4 people up here.
Raiders a lesson. We'll teach them again if they come back.
Yeah, you teach them. Whatever, dude. I'm the one that taught them. And then the scavenging station with some... Whoop, turn the light on. Some random stuff that needs to be turned into component parts. Scav station. Their living quarters. pretty no frills. They got some creature comforts here, but nothing super fancy because they had to haul it all up the stairway or get it dropped off by the vertebrate. Record keeping station. A little lounge area, somewhere to sit and read a book or study. Go out here. And then down on this side, there's just a little wire fence to keep them from falling off. And jump up over here. And then this is how I get up from the bottom. Because I don't use the stairway, I come up the off-ramp. I come up the bent part here. And then these fences just keep me from falling through the holes. But you can cruise right up here. So there's the dish, and of course starlight is that way. The green light, that's the standard for my thing, so I can see that it's on. I haven't had a new person come by in like 2 weeks. Of course, the habit is only 56, so that's probably got a lot to do with it. And then I turn the bus into the restricted area, single unit operator residence. And he just watches the monitors and keeps an eye on stuff. You can kind of see out the window, but not very much. I forgot I left the radio on. Oops. That's okay. So here's the ramps that we built in that last one when I did the workshop tour. Give you another look at the top here. See what we're going to be getting into when we go downstairs. And then go down here. Now you can see down there, there's a guard station right there on the railroad tracks, and Ada's down there. That's at the edge of the build area, and she is constantly shooting stuff because there's lots of raider patrols that go down that road, and they'll come up this dirt path, and she just annihilates them. When she sees them, she starts shooting, and then the whole place empties out and comes down and helps her kill them. So when I was working on this, I heard gunfire a lot. A lot. They attack this place a lot when I'm here, and I'm not quite sure why. I'm going to go down this slow so y'all don't get motion sick because I built it, so I'm used to whipping down this thing at top speed, and it can be a little disorienting. So we'll go down here. We'll take another look at Ada when we get to the corner here. But yeah, she's situated in a very, very good spot. If I was doing something else with this, I probably would have built some houses down there and some turrets because there is a lot of activity that goes on in her range. So let's go to the back of the robot workshop. Ah, I left the door open by mistake. So you've seen this before. If you've seen the workshop video, this hasn't changed very much. I added some more decorations over here. I put some stuff filled up these shelves. But it's pretty much the same as it was. Get that door. So go over here. And I moved the door so the robots can get out. It was giving the iBot problems when it came out because it would just get stuck on the side of the door. But now he just comes right out and just leaves. Goes down the side there. There's a workbench, iBot pods, the robot workbench. Close that up. Oh, so there, here's my engine block. I actually carried this thing all the way down from Drumlin Diner. It turns out that you can pick up heavy stuff, and you know, you walk slow, right? Like with the garbage cans and stuff. But if you throw it, they fly a long way. This thing flew like 150 yards once. I was like, because it kept rolling. It was kind of cool. So we go over here. Here's the original yellow equipment with the workbench. Threw some pylons in there because I found them somewhere. Just stuck them up wherever. Go over here, and there's Jezebel. She watches this approach. They come around this pillar a lot, too. So she alerts to them, and people go crazy. All right, let's go over here. Now, this one does not have the supply depot like the other ones do. And that's because it's mostly robots. So I'm going to theorize that they're pretty good about keeping track of stuff. And they just have to basically report it up to the guys on the top every now and then. So there's no record keeping. There's no fancy stuff. It's just basically a bunch of food on a dock. And the provisioner stops like right over here. So it makes kind of sense. And then Graygarden, of course, like we don't know. So the original house, I didn't really do anything to this. Just added some boxes so they could put their crops in there.
Hello, darling.
Hey, how you doing? Just, that's it. You know, really nothing in here, just new boxes. So to get the happiness up, I added a dog, gave him his own pen, put those little shrubs up there. I think it looks kind of cool up against the building like that. He's like, hey, man, what's up? Where's my biscuit? Yeah, no biscuit for you. So for the mute fruit plants, I went ahead and just built this greenhouse over the top of it. Because it just, it seems like it would just be greenhouses, you know? It's just robots working on plants. So in order to give it protection, to make it look kind of okay, I just went ahead and just dropped this whole structure right on top of it. Built it over by the campfire, dragged it over here, group selected it, popped it in. The lights help do it at night. So, come around the back here. And we got the turret rack up here on top of the thing. Because the enemies come down over that hill a lot, these missile turrets make short work of them. Very, very little difficulty with attacks here. And I think that's really about it for this one. This is a very, very straightforward, simple build. Oh, here. Let me show you this. I put this ladder up here so I can show you the bridge from the bottom. Hopefully y'all can see this okay. I'll stay still for a minute so you can take a look at it. But it was hard to build a structure to go up to the top of it. But that's what the spiral bridge looks like from the bottom. I think it came out pretty good. It took longer than I would have liked, but I'm pretty happy with the effect of it. And like I said, I haven't fallen off of it yet. So, okay, let's go ahead and go back over here. And then we'll take a little quick run through at night and I'll stop yapping so you can see this whole thing. So, we'll put Graygarden right there and I will be right back. And here we are at night. So, let's do a quicker tour this time. We'll go up on the hill, take a look and see what it looks like at night. So here's the whole thing. It's pretty dim. I mean, it's bright up on top, but down on the bottom, it's not too terribly bad. And those lights, those little bulb lights, looked really good in here because they lighted up just enough. You know, it's kind of glowy, but it's not shockingly bright like it normally is with those lights. And your turrets are there. And the dogs over here. Depot's kind of well lit so they can see it. The robot workshop, of course, is very well lit because they do a lot of production stuff in here. Check this door. There's the fusion generator room. We'll go back out the back here. And we'll go up. Actually, you know what? Let's go up the ramp like I normally do. Sorry about the running, but I gotta get back up there. This is probably getting too long. This is how I get up to the top. If I can get over that railing, geez. Just come cruising up here. So there's your bus. And the light. You can see how bright that thing is at night. You can see it all the way in the bottom. I like it. This has the problem with the lights being super dim, even though they're actually on. But I figured that makes sense for the guy trying to sleep. And then the bar area. Still working. Nobody, no customers, but he's just hanging out here. Top of the scaffolding. Nice little lounge area. And of course, they got the same kind of view. Scav area. And of course, my trademark backlit posts. And then from the outside, you really can't see it very well at all, which is what I like. Makes me think they can be sort of unnoticeable if they were to get attacked. The raiders will see the robots and figure that's all there is, if they even look up to see this crazy bridge. So the red light and his house. We'll run through here really quick. See, the observers have a nice good view. The candles don't make them night blind. Of course, this stuff will. But you kind of have to have that when you're working on weapons and armor. Go up the stairs here. Really nice view here. This is one of the higher spots in the game, at least for viewing actual stuff. There's Jalbert back there in the background. And then his sniper range here. Plinking at guys over there at Stray Bandits coming and going from Beantown Brewery. He's like, hey, surprise! Pop! Extra ammo, some water. Sleeping area. And the observation deck, which is, I mean, crazy. You know, I should probably see one day if I can shoot a raider from here. Probably not. They probably won't resolve. And then the escape hatch. And down we go. All right, folks. That's it for Graygarden. We're going to put the sixth one in the can and call it done. Next up will be, I don't know, probably Oberland. That's going to be my next one. It's almost done. It needs something. It's something. It needs some. I don't know what it needs, but it feels like something's missing. I'm not quite sure what. But anyway, I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.